they were Dadaists when it came to music, and it was almost surprising, incredibly funny, stupid, surreal, what else were you, reasonably good musicians. But it was like playfulness is what it was about. The whole thing, it was fun. Everybody was laughing, enjoying themselves, and somehow that communicates to an audience in no way.
It's funny though, to me, they were having a go, taking the mickey, if you like, out of television. I'll do not just say. Then Monty Python went on to sort of do it even with more aplomb and expertise. But did you know that this year is the 25th anniversary of Network?
Network.
The film Network. Really? Yes. 1974.
I'm going to take this.
It just shows you how powerful and influential, you know, satirizing television things can be. Because nobody's taken any notice of Network. Or indeed, you know, the awfulness of, you know, that was highlighted in Python and Do Not Just Yourself. So we all arrive at the end of this voyage of, you know, creativity with a feeling of graceful futility.
Then your autobiography, isn't it?
I've done the pathos now. I mean, the economy. Well, that's the pathos.
So, Etiquette, when you went to the meeting with Humphrey Barclay, did you pitch yourself as an animator or as a writer or what, or nothing in particular?
As somebody to, who wanted to escape from the world of magazines and newspapers and pieces of paper that, you know, I was working on. And he didn't know what to do with me at first, except these two sketches that he forced on the others. And he then went on to do another show called We Have Ways of Making You Laugh. And there was a man named Frank Muir who funded the show. And then there was a group of us who were we were there every week. And they were rather comic people. And not so comic people, as much as boring people as well. And they would comment on things. And I was the guy who drew caricatures of the guests who were appearing on the show. And the camera would, you know, move over my shoulders as I finished my last bit of cartoon, and it makes you the person. And there was one week they had this material they didn't know how to deal with. One of the writers and one of the people in this group on the show had collected about 3 or 4 months worth of the links from a DJ on Radio 1, Jimmy Young. Jimmy Young was this very... How do you throw out Jimmy Young?
But he would get so litigious.
Yeah. He had the most awful, awful punning connections. These words just made him groan every time. And it was 3 months of this material, and they didn't know what to do with it. So I said, well, why don't I just make an animated film of it? I'll do something. And I had over 400 pounds in 2 weeks, or was it 200 pounds in 4 weeks? Whatever it wasn't enough of anything to do anything with it. And I knew something about animation. There have been a couple animators in the 60s in New York in particular who were playing with cutout animation. And I remember there's this one animation where Richard Nixon is talking and it's just his head cut out and flowed over the mouth. He's letting it go. And suddenly his foot goes into his mouth. And so I thought, oh, that's pretty good. It works. And so that's what I did. In these couple of weeks, I had to throw something together. And I took Jimmy Young's head out and cut it out. And it bounced around and the body did things. And these inane puns were bouncing out of his mouth all the time. And it went on television and in Britain. Nobody had seen anything like this. And literally overnight I became an animator. It was as simple as that. So that's all you have to do. So you go to England, live there for a few years, join a comedy group that's doing television shows, and then move on to a second one, and then do some things with some pieces of paper, and you become famous. It's really easy.
But there was a sketch to that end, wasn't there? There was if you want to become rich and famous, become a doctor, find a cure for something no one's ever found a cure for, and be rich and famous.
It's easy. I don't know why more people aren't.
No.
So simple.
Anyway, it worked. And I got a couple more things, and we did this other series of not just stuff. That's when we did the Christmas one. Because that's when I did the Christmas cartoon. Christmas cartoon.
Yeah.
So, yeah. That's eventually we did all.
It was the 60s, Terry. It's all a blur.
I didn't take drugs.
Didn't have to.
I have no excuse except Alzheimer, which is approaching even as we speak. and that's where it started. So what happened at the end of all of that, we got Mike, Terry, Eric, and myself all, we'd done something together. And because the Barnes was so successful and famous, we knew we couldn't ask you to be part of our world. And we and found these hackers are on please and chat me.
Yeah, these hackers.
Yes, who really have no talent. Actually, I think there were actually working doing circus and Rent Boys at the time. and you know, the four of us from the kids' show took them on, and we were given the television series. And that was what's amazing, and it doesn't exist now in most of the world, where the BBC was so laissez-faire, they, once they said yes to something, it just happened. There were no executives you had to go and pitch to. There was nobody doing audience calculations about who the audience is, Democrats. None of this was happening. You just had to get to the head of light entertainment at the bar after 5 o'clock, but not too long after 5 o'clock, about 5 to 10. And if you were lucky, you got a yes. So that was it. The show was on the air. It was almost that simple.
But it was kind of strange in the early days because in their wisdom, there was a particularly exciting snooker match, you know, which is like pool on a big table. It was huge on British television. They'd take 5 minutes off. With the snooker, you know, so it was very annoying, you know, for the Python fans. It was sort of, at last, you know, there's something we can give our teacher to.
The first time they took us off was after the fourth show, we were replaced by the International Horse Show.
Yeah.
But what was wonderful about in the middle of the International Horse Show, people from all the world leaping on their horses, suddenly you heard, da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And they were doing the horse show to that music. There was no way they could see it. They couldn't stop fighting. I mean, well, the first audience was wonderful because they arrived, and they weren't too dissimilar from those middle-aged ladies who were using the clip through every time they had a show. And they'd come to see, you know, a circus, it's going to be all clowns. And the sound of hundreds of jaws dropping is really interesting. Nothing was funny. They weren't laughing. They didn't know what. I think the BBC was also as frightened, and that's why they started to try to disappear. But there was a momentum that seemed to have developed, and they couldn't get rid of it. And we got some very nice critics to tell us, you know, when you did the classrooms, people were writing good things. That helps enormously. And we went on, and it continued with really no involvement. It was only years later that as we became more successful, that they started trying to get involved. And it was always embarrassing because they would, like the headmaster, you know, ask six of us to come up to the office for a discussion. Mm-hmm. And I remember it was the third series of books. It was like, and they had a list of all the things that had to be dealt with. Mm-hmm. They should be cut out of the book. There was the, you know, now the scene where the man thrust the giant penis through the door. What? What are you talking about? You know, and then they asked somebody to sign it. What are you talking about? It's like we had no idea, but this is head of BBC One. What is he talking about? And it turned out it was the sketch where John, at some point, thrust a severed leg through the door and asked it as a receipt to be signed. And there was another sketch that was, and you start realizing what their minds are doing. Incredibly innocent, no matter how silly and, you know, anti-authoritarian and troublesome we were. There was a